And here are some local corporate headlines. Universal Robina breaks ground for its new production plant in Malvar, Batangas. Construction of the manufacturing plant will begin this year and its expansion will span around 10 to 15 years. The plant will directly or indirectly employ around 3,000 workers. And Alternergy, Tanay Wind Corporation, inks a memorandum of agreement with the local government of Tanay Rizal. The agreement pertains to ATWC's construction, eventual operation and maintenance of the 99-megawatt Tanay Wind Farm project.
Malaysian markets capped the week in a sea of green following gains from Wall Street overnight. Leading gains in Asia is Hong Kong's Hang Seng, which closed nearly 2.5%. Japan's Nikkei 225 also on the rise, closing 0.9%. In its intraday high, the index was less than 100 points from reaching a new all-time high. Some positive news from yesterday's report of a technical recession. Singapore's Straits Times Index also climbed as investors await the city-state's 2024 budget statement. Here at home, Philippine shares failed to join the regional upswing as investors cashed in on gains. However, the index was able to notch a fourth weekly gain.
Even a 6.5, 6.7, I would have been very happy. Because me, I personally prefer slow, gradual, rather than these steep increases. Because I totally agree. Maybe in a few days or a week or so, the pundits will take profits and then you'll see a decline and it will go up again. Only because it's an opportunity for people to take profit. So that is normal anyway, but should it dip a little, it's just taking profit. Investors shouldn't be scared because if the economy is doing well anyway, so that and companies are doing better, so their announcements should be very good and their stock prices should be.
Let's check on European markets. They are higher in midday trade as the world's sixth largest economy posts some positive economic data. The United Kingdom posts a stronger than expected retail sales data on Thursday, a glimmer of hope after Thursday's report about the UK economy slipping into a technical recession. According to the London National Statistics Office, retail sales rose by 3.4% month on month, its highest monthly rise since April 2021. That's higher than the 1.5% growth forecast. As for Wall Street, they are mixed after the S&P 500 closed at a record high. Traders are awaiting for producer price data due out on Friday.
And here are some stocks to watch out for. We're monitoring shares of cryptocurrency exchange Coinbase after the company reported its first profit in 2 years. Coinbase shares surged 11.5% before the bell. Also in focus, shares of footwear company Nike, which is reportedly planning to lay off about 2% of its workforce as part of a broader cost-cutting drive. Nike shares are down 0.7% in pre-market trading. We're also keeping a close watch on shares of British bank NatWest, which reported forecast beating profit for 2023. NatWest shares last traded higher by 6%.